केबीएस Good afternoon, students. Yesterday we had the first lecture on the chapter 5, the fundamental unit of life for class 9th science. Okay, so today we are going to do the next topic from the same chapter. Yesterday we knew about the discovery of the cell, how the cell was discovered, who discovered the cell, and who were the different scientists who contributed for the knowledge of existing knowledge of science, whatever we are having about this cell biology. Okay, so before I start my class, I have a very quickie question for you. My question for you is, who has declared COVID-19 as a pandemic? Now, बच्चों हर साल जब हम आपकी नोटबुक्स को चेक करते हैं, आंसर शीट्स को चेक करते हैं, तो बहुत सारे ऐसे बच्चे होते हैं जो क्वेश्चन को लिखते हैं और फिर आंसर में भी क्वेश्चन को ही रिपीट कर देते हैं, और ज्यादातर क्वेश्चंस के आंसर को वो रिपीट कर करके लिखते रहते हैं. तो दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन विच हैज द सेम आंसर एज द क्वेश्चन इज यस, हु हैज डिक्लेयर्ड COVID-19 एज अ पेंडेमिक. And the answer is again the same. Who has declared COVID-19 as a pandemic? With a full stop, not with a question mark. Now what is who? Yes, of course. World Health Organization. So this time you will get this complete one mark if you write the answer as who has declared COVID-19 as a pandemic. The answer is who has declared COVID-19 as a pandemic. But this is the case for only for this question, not for all questions. For all questions, you have to learn the chapter very carefully. You have to memorize certain things and you have to understand the concepts so that you can write the correct answers in correct order and with correct meanings. Okay? So without wasting time, let's move to our chapter. What today we are going to learn? Today, we will try to understand after we have known that how the cell was discovered, we are going to learn about what is the, these are our learning objectives. That means after this session you must know at least these things. One is what is the importance of cell. What is a cell? You know it through your 8th class. You have studied this in your 8th class. Now what is the importance of cell and what are the different components of cell and why? What are the different functions they are going to perform is what we are going to study in this chapter. Now after that we will learn about different types of cells. Okay, there are so many different types of cells and they have so many different functions and their size and shape comes in variety. So we will discuss about some cells over here. After that, we will know how on the basis of number of cells, the organisms are divided or classified. Okay, so we will discuss the division of organisms on the basis of the number of cells. Okay, we will also discuss some activities given in your NCERT textbook. We will discuss the questions based on those activities and why those activities are very important. We will also discuss that. Okay, after that we will learn about the components of cells. At the end of this chapter, we are going to learn about the components of cells. Okay, so students, just one. So students, अगर आपको आपके फ्रेंड्स बोलते हैं कि आपके दिमाग में तो भूसा भरा हुआ है, तो उसे प्यार से समझाना कि मेरे दिमाग में भूसा नहीं, इतने सारे नर्व सेल्स भरे हुए हैं जितने कि गैलेक्सी में स्टार्स भी नहीं है। यानी कि हमारे ब्रेन में इतने सारे न्यूरॉन्स होते हैं या नर्व सेल्स होते हैं जितने कि गैलेक्सी में स्टार्स हैं, उससे भी ज़्यादा। ठीक है, इजंट इट इंटरेस्टिंग? सो यू कैन आस्क योर फ्रेंड्स कि अब ये गलत बातें बोलना छोड़ दें। और अगर मैं बात करूँ डीएनए की, तो अगर हमारी बॉडी का सारा डीएनए लंबा करके खींच के स्ट्रेच किया जाए, तो ये कहाँ तक जा सकता है पता है? अर्थ से लेकर सन तक। सो डीएनए कण, अ सिंगल बॉडी डीएनए कैन गो फ्रॉम अर्थ टू सन। सो वी हैव सो मच ऑफ डीएनए इन आवर बॉडी। एंड इफ वी टॉक अबाउट नर्व सेल्स, अगर आप नर्व सेल्स को एंड टू एंड ऐसे जोड़ते चले जाएं, सो इट कैन टेक द राउंड ऑफ द अर्थ ट्वाइस। यानी कि आप इसे पृथ्वी को दो बार लपेट सकते हैं। वी हैव सो मेनी नंबर ऑफ न्यूरॉन्स इन आवर बॉडी। इसी तरह से अगर हम अपने एल्वियोलाई की बात करें, एल्वियोलाई आर प्रेजेंट इन आवर लंग्स। अगर एक सिंगल एल्वियोलाई को लेकर उसमें हवा कम करनी शुरू करें, तो आपके क्लासरूम के बराबर फूलकर इतना बड़ा गुब्बारा बन जाएगा जितना बड़ा आपका क्लासरूम है। सो कैन यू सी हाउ इंटरेस्टिंग आवर बॉडी इज एंड द सेल्स व्हिच फ्रॉम व्हिच आवर बॉडी इज मेड अप ऑफ। ओके, सो कैन यू गिव मी अ गेस हाउ मेनी नंबर ऑफ सेल्स आर इन आवर बॉडी? Saying, I'm giving you the number 3.72. Now you have to give me the unit. Give me the unit. You think it's million or billion? No, it is trillion. So in our body, we have this much number of cells present. Okay, and our body रोज करीब 300 मिलियन न्यू सेल्स प्रोड्यूस करती है, ताकि हमारी बॉडी ऑलवेज यंग रहे, फ्रेश रहे और अच्छी वर्किंग कंडीशन में रहे। इसी के साथ साथ अराउंड, दिस इज नॉट मिलियन, दिस इज बिलियन, 300 बिलियन न्यू सेल्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड एवरी डे एंड 300 मिलियन सेल्स आर डेड रेगुलरली इन वन डे। एक दिन में हम करीब 300 मिलियन सेल्स हमारी बॉडी में डेड हो जाते हैं और उसकी जगह 300 बिलियन सेल्स नए बनते हैं। अगर आप कभी सुना होगा, अभी हम फेस को स्क्रब करते हैं, हैंड्स को स्क्रब करते हैं, या जब आप नहा लेते हैं उसके बाद आप टावल से अपनी बॉडी को पोंछते हैं, तो अराउंड 40 मिलियन डेड सेल्स को आप शेड करते हैं। 40 मिलियन डेड सेल्स विद ओनली वन वॉश, एक बार नहाने से इतने सारे डेड सेल्स हमारी बॉडी से cells are known as tissues. So If it is single cell, if there are so many cells together having same function, that will be called a tissue, and these tissues will make an organ like our lungs or your stomach or any other organ, and this will make our organ system, and then we have a whole body. So every body is made from cell, whether it is a plant body, whether it is an animal body, or whether it is a plant body or an animal body or any other organism, everything, every living thing is made up of cell. So you can love it, you can hate it, but you cannot ignore it, because cells are very, very, very important for us. Okay, so let's talk about your last memory, which is your oldest memory. Do you remember anything when you were very, very young? Maybe you were going to a nursery school, या फिर आप primary class में जब हमारे school में आए थे. Do you remember anything? Yes. अगर आप अपनी memory की बात करेंगे तो शायद आपको तब की याद हो जब आप 2.5 साल के, 3 साल के, 4 साल के थे, है ना? लेकिन आपकी अपनी life की शुरुआत जब हुई, क्या आपको अंदाजा है आपका size क्या था? Yes, you started with a single egg cell. Everyone. आज अपने आप को कहते हो कि हम बहुत बड़े हो गए हैं, बहुत बड़े हो गए हैं. But your life started with a small egg cell. Okay, let me draw in a big size. So the cell is very small, but I am drawing a little bigger. This is the egg cell. Okay, it was around 12 to 20 micron or micrometer. Now what is a micrometer? If you divide 1 meter by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10 lakh, then becomes 1 micrometer, or it is simply also known as micron. Okay? So you started your journey with a very small cell, and now you are having around 3.75 trillions of cells. Okay, so now let's talk about the activity given in your book. The activity I am talking about is 5.1. Okay, the 5.1 activity, 5.1 gives you a ready hand experience to observe plant cells. Okay, you can see the plant cells through this activity. What we have to do in this activity is we are going to make a temporary mount of onion peel. So this activity is a practical activity, but we are going to learn it theoretically over here. When the school reopens, जब हमारे school खुलेंगे, हम junior science lab में जाएंगे, हम microscope देखेंगे, और उसके बाद हम इसको ध्यान इस activity को करके अपने हाथ से खुद slide बनाएंगे, और खुद slide बनाकर हम उसको microscope के नीचे observe करेंगे और देखेंगे कि plant cells, onion peel cells में कितने beautiful नजर आते हैं. Okay? Now let me tell you, इसमें करना क्या है? एक स्लाइड बनानी है. माइक्रोस्कोप के नीचे देखने के लिए हमको पहले उस मटेरियल को तैयार करना पड़ता है एक स्लाइड के फॉर्म में. उस स्लाइड की फॉर्मेशन को हम कहते हैं माउंट. ओके, एंड दैट प्रोसेस इज नोन एज माउंटिंग. इस किसी भी ऑब्जेक्ट को अगर आपको देखना है माइक्रोस्कोप के नीचे, तो पहले आपको उसे तैयार करना पड़ता है. उस तैयार करने की प्रोसेस को हम माउंटिंग कहते हैं. इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल प्रोसेस. एक दो बार प्रैक्टिस करने से बहुत इजीली आ जाती है. नाउ व्हाट इज एन अनियन पील? कभी आपने अनियन पील देखी है? सो आई हैव दिस अनियन. इस अनियन को जब आप काटते हैं मेरी चिली पनीर बनाने के लिए, तो इसको जब काटते हैं तो इस तरीके की इसमें से स्लाइसेस निकलती हैं. ओके, सो वी कॉल देम एज अनियन लीव्स. सो व्हेन वी टेक वन अनियन लीव, आई हैव टेकन वन अनियन लीव, एंड इफ यू सी, यू कैन सी फाइंड अ वेरी वेरी फाइन लेयर, अ वेरी ट्रांसपेरेंट लेयर. This transparent layer from, you can remove the transparent layer from the onion leaves. Okay, so this one is the onion leaf. Now what we do, we don't take a big piece like this, we take a small, we just put it in water so that it doesn't dry up. Okay, and then we take with the help of a simple forceps, I don't have a forceps at my home, I'm using this plucker. You can take a small piece of it, just put it in water, and we have a glass slide in our lab. Glass slide is nothing but a small piece of glass. A rectangular small piece of glass is known as a glass slide. And on this glass slide, we are going to put this onion peel. But before we do that, what we do, because this is transparent and it is transparent things, because they don't have any color, so we make it colorful, because life is all about colors. So how do we color it and why do we color it? We can see the parts of the cells very clearly. For that we use some dyes or colors. And we don't call them dyes or colors, we call them as stains. Now stains are very important for making the temporary or permanent slides. Now what are the different stains we are going to use in our class tonight? There are different three types. Basically we will use three stains. One is the iodine. You have used iodine in your junior classes also for what? Do you remember? Yes, we have used iodine for the starch test. Okay, so iodine is something which can easily stain the carbohydrates. Okay, so if carbohydrates are present in the cell, so that will get colored into blue or black sometimes if the stain is more. Animal cells. So you can use the iodine stain for both plant cells as well as for the animal cells. It will give a blue-black color to the parts of the cells. Now second stain we have is our, my personal favorite, saffronin. Now saffronin gives pink color or light red color. Okay, so this stain is used for mainly for plant cells. Okay, so the next third stain we are going to use is methylene blue. As the name suggests, what color it is going to give? Yes, of course, it is going to give blue color. Okay, and basically to which parts it's going to give blue color, which are acidic in nature. For example, nucleus has some acidic features. acidic properties. So the nucleus absorbs this methylene blue very easily and it will get a dark blue color. Okay, so this is used for animal foods. Okay, so many times for your MCQs or for your practical questions or for even Viva or for your class quiz or for one mark question in your exam, many times it is asked name the stain which is used for plant cells, name the stain which is used for animal cells, और भी बहुत सारे stains होते हैं. लेकिन अभी हम सिर्फ इन तीन स्टेन्स की बात कर रहे हैं क्योंकि हम अपने क्लास में इन तीन स्टेन्स का प्रैक्टिकल क्लास में इन तीन स्टेन्स का इस्तेमाल करने वाले हैं. ओके, सो प्लीज रिमेम्बर सास्प्रेन फॉर प्लांट सेल्स, मिथाइलिन ब्लू फॉर एनिमल सेल्स एंड आयरिन कैन बी यूज फॉर बोथ प्लांट एंड एनिमल सेल्स. सो लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड. How do we mount the onion peel? We will take the onion peel over here. A small piece of it. We'll put some stain over it, saffronin. Always remember that we take a very very dilute solution of the stain. क्योंकि अगर हम बहुत concentrated solution लेंगे तो फिर वो पूरा पूरा red हो जाएगा, बहुत darkly stain हो जाएगा और darkly stain होने के बाद हमको slide में कुछ भी नजर नहीं आएगा, दैट विल बी ओवर स्टेन स्लाइड. तो हमें ये ध्यान रखना है कि हम बहुत डाइल्यूट सॉल्यूशन बनाते हैं सैफ्रन का, पानी मिलाकर, और फिर उसके बाद इसको स्टेन करते हैं. स्टेन करने के बाद इसको हम वॉश करते हैं 2-3 ड्रॉप्स पानी डालकर ताकि सारा एक्स्ट्रा स्टेन बाहर निकल जाए. उसके बाद हम इसके ऊपर एक ग्लास की कवर स्लिप लगाते हैं. ओके, लेकिन ग्लास की कवर स्लिप लगाने से पहले हम इस पर एक ड्रॉप ग्लिसरीन डालते. ग्लिसरीन क्या करता है, इसको ड्राई हैंड से बचाता है. अगर आपके पास ग्लिसरीन अवेलेबल नहीं है तो आप वाटर ड्रॉप्स भी यूज कर सकते हैं. देन वी पुट अ कवर स्लिप. कवर स्लिप को डालते हुए हमेशा ध्यान रखना पड़ता है कि उसमें एयर बबल्स ना हो, क्योंकि अगर एयर बबल्स होंगे तो आपको ऑब्जर्वेशन में बहुत दिक्कतें आएंगी, आप प्रॉपरली सेल्स को नहीं देख पाएंगे. और इस तरह से कवर स्लिप लगाने के बाद इसको हम माइक्रोस्कोप के अंदर स्टेज पर, दिस इज पार्ट कॉल्ड स्टेज, आप जब माइक्रोस्कोप को ऑब्जर्व करेंगे यू विल गेट द डिफरेंट, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ माइक्रोस्कोप. तो स्टेज पर हम इसको रखते हैं. स्टेज पर इसको रखने के बाद हम क्या करेंगे, इसको ऑब्जर्व करेंगे. और जब हम ऑब्जर्व करेंगे so what we are going to see are the cells of onion peel. This diagram is also given in your NCERT textbook. You can see the cells like this, something similar to the to a brick wall. Now, these are the different cells of onion peel, and this portion which you see darkly stained is a nucleus. Okay, and these are the outer covering. These are known as the cell. Because it is a plant cell, so you can see the cell wall also. And beneath this cell wall, there is another thin layer that is known as the cell membrane. And of course, a liquid is present all over the cell, and this liquid is known as cytoplasm. Okay, so this is the basic structure of the onion peel cells. Understood? Like when we talked about yesterday, when Robert Hooke saw the dead cells of the cork, which he called as, what did he call them? Cells. This was the, these are the cork cells. Okay, these are the dead cells. Now these are living cells, but because we have torn the onion, we have put the stain over it, so they have become dead also. Okay, so you can see the living cells also, you can see the dead cells also. So this is just an example of plant cells. There are so many plants, so there are so many different types of plant cells. Now let's talk about the next activity. Again, which is the same, mounting a temporary, making a temporary mount of an animal cell, and we are taking it as an example, the human cheek cells. This is the 5.2 activity in your NCERT book, activity 5.2, temporary mount of human cheek cells. Now where do we get the human cheek cells? Obviously from our cheek. Okay, what you have to do, you have to take an ice cream stick, एक लकड़ी की आइसक्रीम स्टिक लेंगे, अपने चीक पर उसको हल्का सा स्क्रैच करेंगे. जब आप उसको हल्का सा स्क्रैच करके बाहर निकालेंगे, तो यू कैन सी अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ सेल्स स्टिकिंग टू द आइसक्रीम स्टिक. एंड देन अगेन व्हाट यू हैव टू टेक अ ग्लास स्लाइड, यू पुट सम ऑफ द चीक सेल्स on this side, then again you have to do what? You have to put some water so that it doesn't dry very quickly. If it dries very quickly, you cannot be able to, it will shrink and you will not be able to see the cell properly. So next, what you have to do, you have to put a stain. Now what stain would we use? Because it's an animal cell, so we are going to use methylene. Okay, so if you think you get confused between which is for the animal cell and which is for the plant cell, simply aapka kaun sa favorite color hai? Is it pink or is it blue? Jo bhi favorite color hai usko yaad kar lo. Uske saath P for pink is for what? Pink is for saffronic and P is for plants. Okay, and blue is for animal cells. So you can make mnemonics in your mind according to your wishes, so that you don't get confused and you can remember everything when it is asked in your exam. You do not need to rote memorize everything. When you do it in your practical class, you do it carefully, and once you do it with your hands, you will not forget it for the lifetime. Okay. So similarly, we use methylene blue. We'll put again a very diluted portion of diluted liquid of methylene blue over there. Then we will wash it with two or three drops of water so that the extra stain goes away. And then again, we're going to put some drops of glycerin so that it doesn't dry. And then we will put a cover slip over this. And taking in mind that there are no air bubbles. And then we put it on the stage and observe it under the microscope. And when we observe it under the microscope, what we will find is some irregular shaped structures. For the dark nucleus, and they will be scattered all over. So what is this? This is again a cell membrane. this dark portion is the nucleus, and of course every cell has some liquid matrix, and this liquid is known as cytoplasm. Cyto means cell and plasm means some liquid or semi-solid sort of substance. Okay. So, when we observe the two different types of cells, a plant cell in an NP and an animal cell in human chick cells, we found that each cell is very, very different from the other. But of course, they have something in common also. Same was the case by Charlton and Swan. They also said the same thing. One was observing the plant cells, one was observing the animal cells, and they do found that there are some similarities between two of them. Now let's talk about different types of cells. So, cells come in different shapes and sizes. They have different shapes. Like human chick cells, like the onion peel cells. Okay, for example, your favorite RBCs. You know what is the full form of RBC? Yes, come on, this is red blood cell. Red blood cells, RBCs. RBCs have a beautiful biconcave structure. Okay, they are somewhat like round in shape. Then we have WBCs. Again, come on, what are WBCs? These are the white blood cells. Even some, there are some white blood cells, they can change their shapes also. For example, if it is a macrophage, it is a big one in size with a large nucleus, or some white blood cells be like this, trinucleated. Some will be like this, binucleated. Or some will have a simple nucleus. Or some of them can also change their shapes according to their wishes to fight against the pathogens coming inside our bodies. Okay, so now let me talk about nerve cells. Nerve cell has a very typical structure. And a very interesting structure also. So, it has a central portion, then it has a long tail, and then at the end it has some thread-like structures with nerve endings. Okay, so this is a nerve cell. And we have a special name for this nerve cell that is known as neuron. We call them as neuron. They make our nervous system. Okay? So, now let me talk about muscle cells. They are like this. Spindle shaped. Okay? So these are the muscle cells. And if I talk about a sperm cell, it has a head, then it has a long tail, and it has a head portion which contains a special part that is known as acrosome, then it has a nucleus. Okay, this is a very small sperm cell. Okay, in our body the largest cell is the nerve cell. Bone cell again have a very typical sort of structure. It's a bone cell. Okay, and this is all about the cells present in our body. And if I talk about some unicellular organism or single cell structures, you are very, very aware with your favorite one-celled organism. Yes, it is amoeba having no shape. It can change its shape according to its wish, whenever whatever he likes, he can change its shape. Or some other organism like a Chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas. Or a slipper shape. You learn this in your class 8 chapter, microorganisms. Okay, so you can see there are different shapes of different cells. The shapes of the cells will depend upon their function. What function are they going to perform will decide what the shape is. So next, let's talk about the different sizes of cells. We have different shapes and we do have different sizes. The sizes may vary from 0.001 microns to the size of even 17 centimeters. You know which is the largest cell ever formed? Yes, of course, it is this cell, the egg cell of ostrich. Its size is around 17 centimeters and weight could be around 1.4 kilogram. Egg single cell around 1.4 kilograms. Okay, egg human cell is around 12 to 20 microns. And on the other hand, an ostrich egg cell is around 17 centimeter. I'm talking about the diameter of this, okay? And this is weighing around 1.4 kg. So you can see the diversity. The biology or the life of the earth is full of diversities. Okay? So we have different sizes. For example, I am talking about sperm cell. It will be around 4 microns. Okay? So many of them are microscopic. All of them basically are microscopic, but some can be easily seen with your normal microscope. For some you have to have a very specialized microscope. Okay? So from the above observations, we can conclude that when we observe different cells, there are three major basic things we can observe very clearly. One is the outer layer. This outer layer is known as plasma membrane or the cell membrane. We can observe the nucleus very clearly, and we can observe the liquid matrix, that is known as the cytoplasm. Now, on the basis of number of cells present in them, in the organisms, we can divide them into major two categories. For example, if we talk about human beings or any other mammal like whale or dog, or any, we talk about any fish, do they have a single cell or do they have multiple cells? They have many, but when we talk about an organism like amoeba, how many cells are there? Only one cell. But in humans, we have many cells. Okay, so we can divide or we can classify organisms on the basis of number of cells. Those which have one cell are known as unicellular, and those which have many cells are known as multicellular organisms. Okay, now time song comes for the examples of this. Whenever you write a definition like this, if you give some example, it becomes clear to the examiner that yes, you have read well and you know well. So always try to give, accompany your definition with an example. For example, for here, unicellular, I've already told you what is this, amoeba. You can give the example of amoeba. Or we talked about Chlamydomonas, or you can write the slipper shaped Paramecium. Or you can give any example like Euglena or something, whatever you like. For multicellular, you can give any example like we have given one human. You can write about any name of fish, or you can write any mammal like whale, or you can write and name any bird like pigeon. Or fish you can write Katla, Rohu, or pigeon. I can give any example of an advanced organism. Okay, so now let's come to the question part. What are the different questions that may be asked in your examination? Or I can say that what is the learning objective of today's learning outcomes of today's class? The learning outcome is that the cells have different shapes, sizes, and functions. Okay? So the question may come like, why do different cells have different shapes, size and sizes? The answer would be like they have different sizes and shapes according to their to perform different functions. Then we talked about different stains. One question may come from stains like which are used for plant cells. Name a stain which is used for animal cells. Or name a stain which can be used both for plant as well as animal cells. Okay, now you may get so many quiz questions like which is the largest cell known till date, or like what is the size of a human sperm cell. these small questions which usually comes in your entrance exams can also be answered from this lesson. Now next is very important question, that is the difference between unicellular and multicellular organisms. So this question is asked many a time in your exams, whether it is your PT1, whether it is your final exams, this question may come again and again. So please learn this very carefully. Okay? And then again, the next question is which parts or components of a cell can be commonly observed under microscope . Okay, which are the parts which can be easily observed under the microscope? And you know the answer. The answer is the cell membrane or the plasma membrane, the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Thank you, students. This is all for today, and we wish to learn more in the next class. Thank you so much.